am coming up to one of the major finals in the Olympic Games, the final in the men's 110-meter hurdles. Roger Kingdom, the world and Olympic record holder, but Kingdom unable to make this 1992 Olympic team, eliminated in the U.S. trials, eliminated partly by Tony Dees, who is one of the favorites to win the gold medal in this final event. This event is one of the most demanding in sport, requiring a variety of skills. Here's how Tony Dees runs the hurdles.
I'm Wilbur Ross. I'm the coach of Tony Dees, and I'm going to try to give you a quick clinic, not a lesson, but a clinic in hurdling. First idea is we want to get the first three strides coming out of the block to make certain that he's in a good position to face up at the hurdle. Then he has five strides in which on the fifth stride, he's in what is called a pitch or in the flight stride. On top of the hurdle, we want him to bring the lead arm, bring it across the body, which then establishes what is the torque position in flight. Now, on the downside, I want him to bring that lead arm, to bring it to the rear as the trailing arm. I want him to bring that through with force and what I call it as a reverse movement. When he steps down with that lead leg, we want to get the lead leg down, not with the idea of moving faster, but with the idea of bringing the trail leg down and taking the first running stride on into the next hurdle. Off the final hurdle, I want him to run five strides in, with the arms then being dropped at the waist level so as the torso can be out there to be photographed by the photo timer so as he can get into the finish line as quickly as possible.
So Tony Dees, who will celebrate his 29th birthday on Thursday, focused on the finish line 110 meters away and trying to continue American domination in this event, excluding the boycott year of 1980. The United States has won 17 of the 21 gold medals in the 110 meter hurdles.
Dees calls his coach Wilbur Ross the greatest scientist of hurdling, the Michelangelo of the event. He was only third in his semifinal heat.
Here is the pre-race gold medal favorite, Colin Jackson, whose stock has dropped a little bit through these rounds.
Yeah, he opened up very well in the first round, 13.10, and he's gotten worse in just about every round. He's coached by Malcolm Arnold, who coached John Akibua to the gold medal in the 400-meter hurdles in the 1972 Olympics.
Talk about the revved-up starters. Here's one, Mark McCoy of Canada.
McCoy has been living with Colin Jackson in Wales for the last few months. Says he owes everything to Jackson for getting him back on the track after he took time off for having admitted he used steroids in 88.
One of the tallest hurdlers in the world, 6'7", Florian Schwarthoff of Germany.
I asked Schwarthoff who was his idol among German hurdlers. He said, there are no hurdlers to idolize in Germany. My idol was Ronaldo Nehemiah.
And the U.S. trials winner and silver medalist behind Greg Foster at the World Championships last year. Many think he can win the gold medal tonight, Jack Pierce.
Jack Pierce told me he is the big meat runner. He gets up for the big one, and Dan O'Brien, our broadcast colleague, just saw him downstairs, said Pierce gave him the thumbs up sign. He's ready to run.
Here are the lane assignments for a wide open men's 110 meter hurdle final, including Jackson in lane 3, McCoy in 4, Schwarthoff 5, Pierce 6, D 7, Tony Jarrett of Great Britain in lane 8. There are the two American hopes, Tony Dees with his back to you and Jack Pierce gazing down the track.
As you mentioned, Tom, the Americans have owned this event through Olympic history. Jack Pierce on the right calls himself the ultimate big race runner, but Colin Jackson from Great Britain says it's time for a change. He says he's ready to send a statement to the world that the British are the best hurdlers now.
As Linford Christie did in the 100, another event typically dominated by Americans. McCoy and Jackson away quickly. Here comes Tony Dees and Jack Pierce. McCoy has the lead. Schwarthoff is coming up. Here's Tony Dees. It's going to be McCoy winning it for Canada.
Mark McCoy running 1/100th off his personal best. He wasn't the fastest person in this race, but he had it together. on this day, winning his semifinal and his final.
I believe Tony Dees got up for second, but Mark McCoy, with that super start, took the lead early and held off the rest of the field.
He's always been known for being the fast starter who can't get it done towards the end of the race. In the middle, you're right, he was the first one to that first hurdle, and I think it threw off his training partner, Colin Jackson, alongside of him, who hits hurdles and is then out of the race. But what a consistent race for Mark McCoy. He moved to Wales. He lives with Colin Jackson. It was Jackson that he credits with getting him together. And Malcolm Arnold, the man who coached John Akibua to victory in the 72 Olympics in the 400 hurdles, has done it again. Mark McCoy wins the Olympics. Tom, when you start hitting hurdles in a hurdle race, it's like a drag race over speed bumps. On the left, Tony Dees. On the right, Jack Pierce. Pierce hits most of the early hurdles, which really puts him way behind. Dees is going well until right in the middle of the race when he smashes this hurdle, and that puts him at a disadvantage. They both gathered well. They both came back. They both showed good instincts of leaning at the tape, but it was those early hurdles that got them in trouble and gave the victory to McCoy.
And the official results are in. Mark McCoy of Canada wins the gold in 13.12, with the Americans finishing second and third. Dees takes the silver, and Pierce claims the bronze. Now down to Todd Christensen, who is with the two Americans.
Well, we didn't get a winner, but we got two medalists right here. Great confrontation. Everybody talking about that the U.S. might be out of the medals. That was not the case at all. Jack had a heck of a lean at the end.
Yeah, I needed every bit of that lean. I hit the first hurdle, and that really killed my momentum. I was fortunate enough to pick back up and be able to pull myself back into the race. I didn't win it, but I'm happy with the bronze just the same.
Silver medal in the World Championships and bronze here. It's got to feel pretty good.
One more to go.
Tony, you know, you've had a kind of an off-and-on season. Early on in the season, everybody was talking about that you were the man to beat, and then you had a little bit of a struggle. During the European circuit, a lot of people were down on you, but I would say that the silver medal at this point certainly has rectified a lot of those problems.
Well, I thank God mainly for helping me through this race as I did. I didn't come up with the victory as I planned, as I thought I would, really. Hit a little too many hurdles for that to happen. Mark just ran a great race. I'm happy with the outcome, but I'm not extremely happy like it could have been if it was a goal.
But you know, in retrospect, when you get into a competitive situation as opposed to heats or anything else, you know, it can happen to anybody. And the fact that you guys medal, you got to feel good about that.
Well, I feel great about it, but still, I don't have the goal, but I'm great. Thank God, I love it.
Second and third for the States, not too bad, Tom.